Hello everyone, let's have a quick glance on today's newspaper headlines dated on 9 March 2019. Let us start from the front page of The Hindu. SC appoints three-member panel to mediate in Ayodhya dispute. Committee will start work in Faizabad in a week and file status report in 4 weeks. The chosen three, two legal luminaries and a spiritual leader, all with roots in Tamil Nadu, have been named by the Supreme Court to work towards the mediation of the case, which has been dragging on since 1992. A brief look at the three. Justice F.M.I. Kalifullah, the former Supreme Court judge who will head the panel, began his legal career in 1975 after being appointed to the Madras HC in 2000. He rose through the ranks and was appointed Chief Justice of the Jammu and Kashmir High Court in 2011. He was appointed to the SC in 2012 and retired in July 2016. Shri Ram Panchu, a senior advocate at the Madras HC, he is an expert mediator who founded the Mediation Chambers in 2005. He is president of the Association of Indian Mediators and a director of the International Mediation Institute. He was appointed by the Supreme Court to mediate its 500 square kilometer dispute between Assam and Nagaland. Shri Shri Ravi Shankar, the spiritual leader, has been attempting mediation in a case for some time now. ArcelorMittal to take over debt ridden Isar's steel. Tribunal clears global magnates ₹42,000 crore deal. Takeover tale. August 2, 2017, National Company Law Tribunal NCLT admits insolvency plea against Isar Steel filed by the SBI. November 23, Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code amendment bars promoters of defaulting firms. February 12, 2018, final bids received only from ArcelorMittal and New Metal. October 19, ArcelorMittal says Committee of Creditors COC has tagged it as H1 or the preferred bidder. October 26, Ruiz offer ₹54,389 crore for settlement of the entire admitted claims of creditors and employees. October 27, COC approves ArcelorMittal bid. January 29, 2019, NCLT junks ₹54,389 crore settlement. March 8, NCLT approves ArcelorMittal's ₹42,000 crore bid for Isar Steel. Modi slams assault on Kashmiris. Rafael documents not stolen, AG does U-turn. Only 3.32 lakh MSME jobs created in last 4 years, finds CII survey. Government data for 2012 to 2015 recorded 11.54 lakh new jobs. You will be in trouble if anything is done to Aravali, Supreme Court warns Haryana. Now, North and East News. Rajasthan cuts Lokayukta's tenure to 5 years. Reversal of Rajya government's decision abruptly ends incumbent's term. CPIM announces names for 2 seats in Bengal. Now, Nation News. Do forest surveys separately? Trees in plantations, private lands should not come under it, says expert panel. Miles to go, bringing at least 33% of India's area under forests has been a goal since 1988. In 2017, 21.53% of its geographical area was forest. Kambalakonda Forest in Visakhapatnam. Cancer drugs 87% cheaper after trade margin cap. UIDAI to levy fees for verification. Banks exempted from charges. Agencies should deposit the eKYC charges in 15 days. Gadkari flags off project for Delhi-Mumbai Expressway. Hard landing, all that remains. The debris of the MiG-21 fighter's jet of the Air Force that crashed near Bikaner in Rajasthan on Friday. The pilot ejected safely, the Air Force said, adding that a bird hit could be the likely cause of the crash. Nirav's bungalow in Raigad demolished, razed through controlled explosions. The remnants of the structure of Nirav Modi's mansion seen in Alibag off Mumbai coast on Friday. You will be in trouble if anything is done to Aravali. Supreme Court warns the Haryana government. The Aravali range near Ajmer, Rajasthan, bid to form new coalition in Nagaland without BJP. 19 MLAs of NPF, Naga People's Front, go into a huddle at resort. Now, editorial news. Strange turn. The Supreme Court's attempt at mediation in the Ayodhya dispute is incongruous. A peace movement is needed. India and Pakistan must reimagine the border as a fold of peace instead of as a threshold of hostilities. The case for a first front, a third or federal front will not be able to confront the challenge the Hindu right poses to India's secular polity. Road through Rome, Italy's proposed endorsement of the BRI highlights the dilemmas within the EU. Now, ground with large swathes of the Bandipur forests still dry, the risk of wildfires will continue to haunt the authorities until the southwest monsoon sets in again. Forest fires raged in the Bandipur Tiger Reserve in February, when Bandipur burned. This is the picture of burned Bandipur forest. The forest fires that erupted in Bandipur Tiger Reserve last month devastated hundreds of acres of pristine forest. R. Krishna Kumar and E. M. Manoj report on the mammoth effort that went into containing the fire and the need to upgrade firefighting capabilities. Uncontrolled forest fires over vast areas not only destroy habitats and food sources of wildlife but also kill smaller mammals, birds, insects and reptiles. Bandipur Tiger Reserve location. The rise in temperature coupled with the dearth of summer rains had turned the entire forest area into a tinderbox. Temple row, with the Ayodhya case hearing likely only after the Lok Sabha election, a brief chronology of the case in the Supreme Court from December 5, 2017 to March 8, 2019. Karsevaks demolishing the Babri Masjid on December 6, 1992. Hope all obstacles will be cleared. RSS. Parties hail SC order. Court's decision should be final and binding on all parties, says Congress. Another door opens. Akhil Bharatiya Hindu Mahasabha Chief Nand Kishore Mishra, Nirmohi Akhara, Mahnat Sitaram Das and Petitioner Kartik Chopra outside the SC. RSS Conclave slams court. Kerala government on Sabarimala. BJP gives up one LS seat in Jharkhand, ties up with AJSU for Giridih seat. AJSU is All Jharkhand Students Union. Narendra Modi arriving for the BJP meeting. BJP Congress spar over AG's clarification on Rafael papers. Shah rebutes Rahul's remarks on stolen document. Begin probe with Parikar, says Rahul. Only 3.32 lakh MSME jobs created in 4 years. Modi slams assault on Kashmiris in Lucknow. Congress reopens talks with SP-BSP. Back channel effort is underway to avoid division of anti-BJP votes in key state. SP fills Mulayam from Manipuri seat. Now news of 11th pace. We want peace, not war, Imran. We will not allow any militant group to function from our soil. Pakistan PM extending olive branch. We should resolve our issues through dialogue and have peace and trade, said Imran Khan. Balakot airstrike site still off limits. On duty a CRPF Jawan during a shutdown called on Friday to protest against the detention of JKLF chairman Yasin Malik and the arrest of Jamaat-e-Islami leaders. Jammu grenade thrower is a minor. He is a class 9 student, says police. Army Jawan goes missing. India-Pakistan must have long-term vision for ties. China reiterates advocacy for dialogue. Wang Yi. US wants more irreversible action on terror from Pakistan. Islamabad urged to abide by UNSC obligations. Government trade to the Hindu unacceptable, says INS, Indian Newspaper Society. Calls for repeal of the Official Secrets Act. India to send envoy back to Pakistan. Had withdrawn him post Pulwama, Ajay Bisaria. PM's speeches are insightful, says Jaitley. Finance Minister releases compilation of Narendra Modi's speeches. In print, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley releasing the book Sabka Saath Sabka Vikas in New Delhi on Friday. Now world news. Paul Manafort sentenced to 47 months for fraud. The former campaign chief of Donald Trump was also ordered to pay a $50,000 fine and $24.8 million in restitution. Convicted and jailed, Paul Manafort at a federal court in Washington in December 2017. Taliban denies discussing ceasefire with the US. Whistleblower killed in Pakistan. Kohistani had drawn attention to an honor killing incident of Charles Kohistani. China plans new foreign investment law. Bill 6-2 assures concerns about the country's business environment. China's president Trump's communications director Bill Shein resigns. He will serve as an advisor for president's 2020 run. Bill Shein, the latest in a string of communication chiefs to quit. Public blames US for summit breakdown, says and Korea. US President Donald Trump and North Korea leader Kim Jong-un in Hanoi in February. State media acknowledges that meet was fruitless.